Bob Hazen is in Pittsburgh's Troy Hill section tonight to show us how this all played out. Bob, unbelievable.
Yeah, really. People here believe this crook has been hitting places around Troy Hill in recent weeks, even stealing from restaurants, cars, and a chapel across the street here. But today, he picked the wrong congregation to mess with. The morning services here at Most Holy Name of Jesus Church in Troy Hill were unlike any other.
It's sad because these type of individuals prey on the elderly, and they realize that they think that, you know, no one would do anything in church.
Father John Danello says his church has been watching out for this man, 31-year-old Eric Cirilla, since a woman's purse was stolen from church last week. Today, the congregation was settling in for the 9 a.m. service when Cirilla allegedly showed up in shorts and high tops. The pastor here says Cirilla walked in about 10 minutes into the service and sat in one of these back pews. And while parishioners went up to get communion, he walked up towards the front, looking down the aisles for purses. And when he found one, wrapped it up in a newspaper like this one, then ran towards the back.
But the crook probably didn't expect what happened next. Ushers, including Glenn Hubert and Port Authority Police Chief Steve McCauley, jumped into action.
Steve McCauley, he grabbed the guy by his throat. And so then I ran up and grabbed them too, and we were wrestling with them to try to get them down.
Then the pastor signaled Mike Chernosky to help out.
Yeah, I put my hands down and hurdled two pews, one pew at a time.
Chernosky says he put Cirilla in a chokehold, and the group held him down for 15 minutes right next to the confessional, with the alleged thief even biting Chernosky at one point. Parishioners say Cirilla even explained why he did it. He said he needed money for drugs.
He has an addiction. He was sorry, and he was glad he was getting caught. Hopefully that was true.
Finally, police arrived and arrested Cirilla, and this church hopes it sends a message to any other crook.
And it's sad that it had to happen in church, but we're not going to let it happen here or in our community or in our homes.
Well, hopefully this will deter them from doing it, and especially at a church, that there are people watching them.
Well, right now, Cirilla is in jail. He's facing a charge of theft. Of course, more charges could be coming as well if he is linked to those other attacks in the neighborhood. Reporting live from Troy Hill, Bob Hazen, Channel 4 Action News.
Quick action.